సముద్రం అంటే ఫస్ట్ చాలా భయం. అట్లాగే 1 ఇయర్స్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్లోనే పెద్ద పెద్ద అలలు వచ్చినా కానీ నేను కంట్రోల్ చేసుకుని అటు మంచి సెయిలింగ్ చేయగలుగుతాను.
So at the end of the day, this is all about opening up horizons and managing aspirations. Very often we deal with children who don't have scope about what their future is going to be like. They have a very limited set of aspirations. They don't have adequate number of role models.
Mummy, mo, housewife, daddy, farmer, sailing kochina kanunchi mimu. Asal ekarna na, ellalanna ekarna na, vere state akar ellalanna asal bai pade tholam. Ipraite ekarna na, dare galochu. ఎక్కడైనా ఎలా ధైర్యం ఉంది, ఎక్కడ వెళ్ళి సీలింగ్ చేయగలుగుతాం.
ఇక్కడ మాకన్నా పెద్దవాళ్ళు కూడా మాకు మంచి నేర్పించారు. వాళ్ళ వల్లనే మేము సెలెక్ట్ అయినాం సీలింగ్లో.
రవళి దీది, నాపిక దీది, జీవన్ అక్క, జాన్సీ అక్క, ప్రీతి అక్క ముజే సికాయ హై అచ్చే టాకింగ్ జైవ్ సబ్ సికాయ ముజే అచ్చే.
మే బహుత్ ఖుష్ హూం ఉడ్బో స్కూల్ సే ఔర్ వైసీ హెడ్ సే థ్యాంక్ యూ.
So this has been one hell of an exercise in terms of perseverance. They have stayed with the sport for the last 3.5 years, and championship after championship, they've come to the top of the Indian fleet now, and it makes us at the Yacht Club of Hyderabad and all of them, I'm sure, feel very proud about where they stand today. Am I right about that?
Yes, sir.
So you may wonder how this whole thing started and you know, what really drove me. I was sailing for about 30 years prior to having thought about the idea of starting the yacht club. The competition was limited because the access to water, the access to the sport, it was a very exotic rich man sport. And getting access to it meant you needed to have a membership of a club, you needed to be either part of the army or the navy. Given the vast coastline that we have, given the fact that there is so many lakes and now cleaner and cleaner lakes, it's very sad that infrastructure for water sports, be it sailing or rowing or whatever, is very, very limited, and therefore access. I decided that at the Yacht Club, we need to fix this problem once and for all. And I went up to the officer on special duty, an IFS officer at the Hussein Sagar, and I asked him, like, we wanted to start a charitable sailing club, and would you be interested? So he said, oh, this is a fantastic idea. And that was music to my ears, and he said, okay, you'll need to meet the Metropolitan Commissioner, an IS officer at that point of time. So I said, okay, fine. In 15 days, they got me a meeting with the Metropolitan Commissioner. I walked into his room, and he was reading my proposal down, and I sat down, fidgeted a bit, and then I asked him, sir, when can we have this permission? So he didn't look up, and he just said, when do you want this permission? So I just jokingly said, sir, how about tomorrow morning? He didn't look up, and he just said, how about tonight? So my faith in government went to the roof at that point in time. This was the kind of jetty that was given to us almost immediately the next morning. Paperwork took a little bit of time, and this is the transformation. Look at the trees, and look at the... This is what the Yacht Club looks like today. For 25 years prior to the Yacht Club, there was almost no sailing amongst kids in Hyderabad. So 25 years blank. During a championship, this is what it looks like today, boats peppered all. Some of you passing by Tangbar and Hussein Sagar will see this kind of a situation pretty often happening these days. We started with just 3 boats, and today we have 120 boats lined up on the jetty. So let's talk about Rajnikant. We started with about 4 kids. We went, 3 kids came in from the government school, Mona Market. They'd be walking 4 kilometers up to our Hussein Sagar, barefoot and going back. Of course, later on we gave them shoes and bikes and things like that. One day I came to the club and I saw these 3 kids practicing, and I found a little boy on the jetty with 2 buckets of water and helping around. So I just asked him, what are you doing here? He says, my brother works nearby, so I'm just helping everybody here. So I said, where are you from? So he said, I'm from Remagada village in Vanaparthi. I said, are you studying? So he looked about 11 or 12 years old. I said, are you studying? So he says, yes, I'm studying. I said, do your parents know that you're here? He says, no, I don't have any parents. I said, instead of all this, would you like to just learn how to sail? You see these three boys in the water, would you like to learn how to sail? He said, sure. I said, then go ahead and learn how to sail. He just dropped the buckets and he ran to learn how to sail. And this is Rajnikanth, in 2 years, national champion. That's it. This kind of press coverage he had got. And today, he's a life-saving specialist qualified with us at the Yacht Club. Amongst the four kids who joined us, here are all four of them. Two of them are now, have graduated, are working towards their post-graduation or a government job. And Rajnikanth, of course, is with us, and one of them is a physical training instructor at a private school. A moment of inspiration. I mean, there's always this inflection point in your life when you get a little inspired to do something and maybe carry that through your life. While I was in college, the sweepers and the toilet cleaners were the most exploited on campus. They were not permanent. They were very low salaries. And so I would keep giving them odd jobs for 3-4 years. I was a campus magazine editor. I was the film. I was looking after the festival. And I was looking after the canteen. So I'd keep giving them odd jobs so they did make some more money. In my final year, I woke up one day and I found 50 of them outside my room. I got up and said, maybe something's wrong. And they said, no. They brought the authorities of the campus to my room and said, this is the guy we want to represent us to the management from today onwards. I was thereafter conferred the title of the student representative of the toilet cleaners and the sweepers of IIT Madras. It was a very, very proud moment in my life. I was honored. That surely played a role in the kind of work I'm doing today. The growth story, I'll just show you this. The first sailing event we went for was in Khadakwasla Lake. Five of us, five kids in 2011. Then we had eight kids, Chennai Harbour 2012. Bhopal 2014, 11 kids. India International Regatta 2015, 13 kids. Chennai Harbour December 2016, 25 kids. 32 Krishnapatnam. Marwe Beach, recently in May, we went up to 60. And that's not enough. 131 today. And growing. We want to move up to 500. So we've had our share of celebrities who've come to campus. Celebrities mean a lot to everybody, including us. Rana, our very own Rana, had come down to learn a little bit of sailing. I'm sure there are a lot of Rana fans, like Rajnikanth fans. VVS Lakshman, the very, very special Lakshman. Rahul Dravid came, spent an entire day. Our very own little Sachin. Sachin came to the Yacht Club as a little baby. And he started to learn to sail. That's him there, learning to sail from Gautam. Gautam was also a 14-year-old or a 12-year-old at that point in time. That's little Sachin there in the thing. Just 6 months later, he's out in the Bay of Bengal and waves maybe about 2 meters high. And he wins two medals, a bronze at an international and the nationals. This is Sachin. And then he joins the Navy. He joins the Navy and he meets the Minister of Defense. Not quite Sachin Tendulkar, but a terrific success story of another little Sachin. The armed forces. So what is the purpose of our work at the Yacht Club? Through the medium of sailing, we'd like to actually work with children, make their lives a lot more significant, and pull them and their families out of poverty. That's the whole focus. Our boys learn to sail at the foundation. They sail at the national level, at the international level, and then thereafter join the Navy and the Army. At least, this is the children and their parents at the Yacht Club. This is a picture of them having just been recruited into the Navy and the Army. And this is them with a naval officer now, which is 2 years after they've joined, and they've participated in the national championship. Small story of two boys from Rasulpura is a small little shanty town near Begumpet. We work very closely with the IIM Ahmedabad-funded school called Udbhav. And two little boys, Durga Prasad and Gautam Kankatla, here's Durga for you, came, just walked into the club one day and wanted to learn how to sail. Pretty random. And this is Durga on his first few days. State champion, pretty fast. National champion, this is him being carried by his compatriots. And then it doesn't stop. They're Asian. He represented us at the Asians. Durga Prasad leaves for the World Championships. So you represented India at the World Championships. This is Gautam, his friend, state champion, national champion, that's a bronze, national champion here. Today, Gautam is being employed by one of the leading sailing coaching institutes in Portugal. He's heading there very fast. Juhi and Tanish Desai joined us. Juhi was really tiny. She was just about 8 years old. And we thought she was too small, too fragile to join the gang. But the parents said, whatever Tanish does, Juhi has to do. There's no two things about it. And Juhi agreed with that idea. But this is how, what they looked like when they joined. Just 5 years later, state champion Tanish and you have Juhi became India number one in 2018, which is about 8 years later. This is them, along with Durga Prasad, representing us at the Asians, representing the country. Rishabh Nair lives somewhere nearby here, Nizampet. It takes him 2 hours to come there. He found us on the internet as an 11-year-old, dragged his parents across to the club and said, this is the sport I want to learn. Nothing else, no cricket, no tennis, nothing. This is what I want to learn. And 2 hours, they did that for many years. He became state champion. It's pretty much the standard trajectory, state and then country. National champion 3 years in a row, entirely his own doing, parental support, 15, 16, and 17. Moment of serendipity, in 2017, he won the national champion and I won the Masters. So it was absolutely on the same day. Story of Sirisha Curry from Padigyal village. She came and she was very difficult to work with, angry, indifferent, cold. She did not want to sail, she did not want to eat. And, well, she sailed for about a year. She was selected for a senior fleet in Bombay. We went there, there was a senior fleet and a junior fleet. She was coming 40th and 50th in the senior fleet. So towards the end of the training program, I asked, anybody wants to move to the junior fleet, you might stand a better chance there. So two kids volunteered, one boy and Sirisha. And she moved into the junior fleet. She won gold. Now, yes, it was a come down. I mean, she went down to the fleet and she won the gold. But she won the gold, she won the gold. When she came back at the railway platform, the entire village of Padigyal was there with the schoolmates and everybody was there to greet her. It boosted her a hell of a lot. Here she is with none other than RS Praveen Kumar being felicitated at the school. She came back to Hyderabad for the next championship. And this time we said, which fleet? She said, senior fleet. And she was smiling and she was full of confidence. Today, she is ranked 6th in the state and 12th in India. So this is the springboard of going down and then springing back into a totally new realm that gives them the confidence. And we've learned a lot from this experience. Nalakutta Government School, Preeti Kongari, she's here with us. You'll see her very soon. That's her when she joined, second from right. She joins the Navika program, which we'll talk about in a few seconds. Here she's learning the ropes, tiny little Preeti learning the ropes on shore from a senior who was also national champion. Here's state just sub-junior champion, national champion 2019, just 2 months ago. That's Preeti Kongari for you. We did bring some out-of-the-box ideas to the state, and one of them was Batkamma on the water. You can see our sailors on the water doing a little bit of Batkamma. We also created the Coracle Racing Fraternity now from Konasima, Srisailam, and so many lakes in Telangana. This is the Navika project. The word Navika means female sailor. So we have a completely girl-focused program. These are the girls over here. We give them a 360-degree, 24/7 attention. We take them from wherever they are, maybe 9 years old, 8 years old, right up to graduation. Here are the girls when they joined us. This was about all. You'll see some of them now on stage. And this is what they look like. Preeti Kongari. This is them in full action. Lakshmi Nukarantnam. Jhansi Priya Laveti, India number 5. Dharani Laveti, India number 6. Vaishnavi Veeravamsham, India number 8. Ravali Parandi, India number 9. Thank you very much. You have India number 3, 4, and 5 right in front of you here in the slide, practicing. They are all, as soon as we finish this program, we have lunch, and the entire team is going to Oman for the Asians. Out of the 10 children selected for the Asians from India, 6 are from Telangana, from our club. That doesn't stop there. As soon as we come back, within 10 days, we're all headed for Spain and Portugal for the Atlantic Week. We've been invited there. So what have we done? In summary, 6 national champions, 4 state champions, 13 international, 68 medals, 8 joined the Navy and 2 joined the Army. Dignity through sports is our tagline. I've always wondered, you know, be it come, be it literature, be it engineering, be it, you know, any kind of a good idea. I mean, is it coming from our hearts and minds, or is it there somewhere in the soul of the universe, and we are just the messengers? So I feel that at the end of it all you need is a little bit of madness, insane sincerity, and the universe will come together and help you take the world from where it is to where it ought to be. So, whenever you come up with an idea, you feel it's going to be transformational or whatever, however small, however big, come up with an idea, and you don't know when to start, remember the IAS officer who I first met, and ask yourself that little question. How about tonight? Thank you.